أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
After reciting the tashahhud, ta'awuz and surah al-fatiha, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih the Fifth, ayyadahullahu ta'ala binasrihi al-aziz, stated, Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah. Having manifested the blessings and favours of Allah the Almighty, Jalsa Salana UK came to a conclusion last week. These 3 days were filled with blessings and it left a positive impact on both Ahmadis as well as the external guests. I will present the sentiments of some of these external guests. But before I do so, I would like to thank the workers who played a role in the organization prior to Jalsa, during Jalsa, after Jalsa, and are even working until now. By the grace of Allah the Almighty, the members of the Jamaat, men, women and children, all have a special quality which is commended by even the guests who attend. And this is a form of silent tabligh which is carried out by the workers who fulfill their responsibilities. And the workers of every department of the Jalsa Salana play a crucial role in this. Whether they are on the entry routes, at the gates, at the security check, in the car park, serving food, cooking food, cleaning, or whether it is the children doing duties such as giving water as well as other duties that the children perform, every department that operates during the Jalsa Salana appears to be operating extremely diligently and deserves to be thanked. There are minor shortcomings which some may observe as well. However, these shortcomings should be overlooked in such large-scale arrangements. In any case, all those performing these duties, in addition to serving the guests, are carrying out a form of silent tabligh. And many people, including the external guests, express their sentiments of praise and have also sent them in writing as well. Similarly, through MTA International, people residing in various countries of the world are also grateful for the excellent transmission of the program of the Jalsa. And so I would like to thank all the workers this year, alongside the workers from the UK. For the first time, a large delegation consisting of Khuddam and volunteers from Mauritius came, and they worked very hard. Similarly, Khuddam from Canada who came, who are helping with the wind-up, may Allah the Almighty reward all of them. And the coverage by the press and media this year was very good as well. Similarly, the traffic was managed excellently and the neighbors were happy as well. Every year we receive complaints from them. However, this year we did not receive any complaints. As a matter of fact, they thought that the attendance was less than last year and that this was because the flow of traffic was very smooth. In fact, the attendance was 2,000 more than previous year. And when they were informed of this, they were astonished. MashaAllah, this was managed excellently. And one of the counselors in this area is an Ahmadi and a missionary. He worked in an excellent manner in forming relations with the neighbors and in planning the traffic. May Allah the Almighty reward him as well. In any case, I will now present some impressions about the Jalsa. And may Allah the Almighty open the hearts of those who express these impressions and enable them to understand the true meaning of the message of Ahmadiyyat. And may we also fulfill and acquire the purpose with which the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam was sent. And this should not be limited to these 3 days. Rather, we should make this a part of our lives. Ismail Belin Sahib of French Guiana participated in the Jalsa Salana. He had a long-standing connection with the Jamaat, but had not done the Ba'ath yet. However, he did have the opportunity to do the Ba'ath during this Jalsa. He says that I have never in my entire life seen such an event where people of all major languages and ethnicities of the world gathered. After attending this Jalsa, my faith has changed into conviction that this indeed is the true Jamaat and the Jamaat of Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. If we do not answer the call of the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, by accepting the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam as the Imam of the age, then we shall remain in misguidance. He further says, I am certain that Allah the Almighty has guided me to this path, and if the Muslims wish to unite today, then they must do so by entering the fold of Ahmadiyyat and joining this blessed Jamaat at the hand of the Khalifa. He then further states, the preparations of Jalsa Salana are unparalleled. Every single worker was seen smiling, and there was no hypocrisy on their face. Every single worker was serving the guests with heartfelt joy. I did not know anyone, yet everyone would meet me as though we had known each other for years. He continues that I became a Muslim and was a Muslim for many years prior to attending the Jalsa and strived to follow the teachings of Islam, but I always felt as though something was missing. However, after participating in the Jalsa, I felt as though that shortcoming was fulfilled. Yoshida Sahib, a Buddhist chief priest of Japan, was also in attendance. He says that we attended all the sessions of the Jalsa. My wife also went to the ladies' side. We saw the exhibitions and spent some time at the bazaar. And one thing that was typical everywhere was that the volunteers serving were all seen to be ever ready and alert. From the first day to the last moments, the fervor and passion of the workers was unchanged. The Ahmadi friends attending were all extremely hospitable and friendly. When people from over 100 countries gather in one place, you are bound to find some differences and a number of issues may arise. However, the morals and behavior here all seem to be the same. Whenever someone was stopped, they would stop there and then, and whenever the people were called to prayer or to the Jalsa proceedings, they would reach there without delay. He says that for us, experiencing the Jalsa was unforgettable. They also met me and I told them that believing in one God is necessary and that they should ponder over this and contemplate upon this. Likewise, I advise them to have love for humanity. He says, being a Buddhist, I am not accustomed to the belief in one God. However, my heart says that there must be a creator and master of this universe and that we all are his creation and that we can all attain nearness to this creator and master. As it were, they have now begun to consider taking steps towards Allah the Almighty. Aziz Naziri Sahib, a guest from Kosovo, was also in attendance. He says that this was my first opportunity to attend the Jalsa, and I'm very happy. Everything was running in an orderly fashion. The speeches were especially beneficial. And after listening to the addresses of the Khalifa, I felt a spiritual transformation in myself, and I shall take that back with me. He then further states that praying here brought peace to my heart. I am an old man, so I pray that I am able to participate in such a spiritual environment next year. Such a spiritual atmosphere has filled my heart with love for Islam Ahmadiyyat. And wherever I go, I will certainly mention it, and I will also draw other people's attention towards studying the true teachings of Ahmadiyyat. And I will definitely mention the concluding address of the Khalifa of the time, which was filled with countless proofs, because I myself am a witness to this. He then says, before taking the bed, the city's name of where he lives is either Bashardina or something along those lines. But in any case, he says that there was a Jamaat mission house there, close to which there was a shop. When I would go to this shop, whenever the owner found out that I had gone to the mission house to pray, he would say that not go to the mosque, because these are Qadianis who have created a new prophet. And this new prophet would, God forbid, curse the holy prophet, peace be upon him, and has introduced innovations in Islam and changed Islamic teachings. But I continued attending prayers regularly and kept seeking answers to my questions. And Allah the Almighty enlightened my heart to accept Ahmadiyyat. Now, after listening to this address, I once again realized how non-Ahmadi opponents try to distance people from the Jamaat. Nevertheless, I will go back, and putting this address in front of people will respond to them based on the writings of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wassalam. Umar Gebur Sahib, who is from Chile and works as the Director of Worship in the National Government of Chile, says that it is part of my duties to guide the Chilean government on the registration and other matters of all religious organizations established in the country. He further states, I sought opinions about the Ahmadiyya community from the Muslim organizations established in the country, and they all expressed negative views, and the summary of which is that they are not Muslims. He says, at the Jalsa, I met your Khalifa, and after that, I promise your community that I will do my utmost to fulfill my own responsibilities and share my personal experiences with the people in my circle of influence, and inform them that Ahmadis are not only Muslims, but the best and exemplary Muslims. He says that I will also make every effort to establish your community in Chile. He said that he particularly liked the first day's address of the Khalifa, in which he gave a sermon on discipline and administrative matters himself. He states that I have attended many religious gatherings, but I have never seen any religious leader himself providing guidance on administrative matters. I was very surprised and happy to hear this sermon because this action shows that your Khalifa makes efforts for the spiritual, moral, and administrative improvement of the community. A lady from Holland, Mrs. Patricia, says that first of all, I would like to thank you for your hospitality during Jalsa Salana UK 2024. Many people from different parts of the world were present, and it was a profound display of brotherhood. There were people from countries like Indonesia all the way to America. She further says, I participate in your events like the peace walks and peace symposiums, and now coming to this Jalsa was my next step. She says that here I saw that handling thousands of participants on a daily basis and taking a village and constructing it, including all logistics and all facilities, was very well managed. A large number of people were seen cooperating with each other, and there were no lines, and people were cleaning as they went along. She states that I would like to congratulate all the workers and the volunteers of the Jalsa. Witnessing young students and everyone partaking in every little task and working together for a greater purpose is always uplifting. She further states, "Having participated in the various sessions, I felt a sense of peaceful togetherness, and I will specially take the memory of the international bed ceremony with me forever." She says that if every human being in the world increases their empathy for humankind and raises their own consciousness for humanity just as the community is doing, then international problems can certainly be resolved. A guest named Thomas Reynolds Sahib from Argentina, who was representing Argentina's National Secretary of Worship, says that, "I watched this annual convention, i.e. Jalsa Salana, with wonder and amazement. The excellence and pristine organization with which you have all managed this huge gathering." He further explains, "In our country, it is impossible to have such an event. And even in the presence of the police, such discipline is unimaginable." And with regards to the address of the Khalifa to the women, "I was very impressed by the fact that you are not moved by societal pressures and instead stand firm on your principles." He goes on to say that, "Although as a Christian I did not agree with all of your doctrines, but with particular regard to the points on family life, I have benefited greatly despite not being a Muslim." A guest named Dr. Christy Chang Saiba from Taiwan observed, "Now when we were received at the airport, it was with a deep spirit of hospitality. Then we had the opportunity to partake in the Jalsa, where we witnessed thousands of volunteers serving in their duties. I was left in total amazement. I have attended many huge conferences all over the world, but have never witnessed such a huge gathering being organized through volunteers." The Khalifa of the time imparted many beautiful pieces of wisdom during the address to the ladies on how young women should conduct themselves in life. "During the address, I was observing the expression on the faces of the young girls and the concentration with which they were listening to this advice. And it showed that the Ahmadi girls and youth have great love for their Khalifa. As I was meeting the head of the Ahmadiyya community for the first time, I expected that it would be done in a very formal manner and with a great deal of protocol. But I was surprised to see that it was extremely comfortable and informal setting, where His Holiness asked how we were doing and also inquired about Taiwan." She goes on to say that, "We had many questions for him, but the time passed so quickly in us answering his questions about Taiwan that we didn't get the opportunity to ask anything else." In any case, the Jalsa left a positive impact on them. There was also another guest from Taiwan named Dr. Frank Saib. He says that he traveled a long distance to be part of this Jalsa. He explains that after leaving Taiwan, he had only reached Beijing when a flood hit Taiwan, and so the flight was cancelled. Yet, he says that, "I was still successful in my journey and reached safely, and I could feel that our trip on this occasion is miraculous." He then says that when we reached the Jalsa, we felt that this was the decree of God that we should partake in this Jalsa. When the head of the Ahmadiyya Jamaat explained in the inaugural address of the convention that this is not a materialistic or worldly gathering, but rather a spiritual one, my attention again reverted to the fact that it is certainly God's special and miraculous decree that has brought us here despite the difficult circumstances on the backdrop of our travel. He explains that, "My wife and I are amongst the very first people from Taiwan to participate in Jalsa Salana, and we are returning back with firm resolve to inform the people of our country that Jamaat Ahmadiyya is an extremely peace-loving, highly organized, and truly moral community, and we intend on encouraging more guests to come every year from Taiwan to attend the annual convention." Then there was a guest from Canada who seems to be of an Iranian origin, Yasin Ahmadi Saib, who has a PhD in philosophy and is also a journalist. He says, "I found the Jalsa Salana of the Ahmadiyya community to be a remarkable display of wisdom and reasoning in the form of a religious gathering. The spirit of Jalsa Salana was full of signs of equality among Muslims, And from the very first moment I attended this gathering, I felt that Muslims had moved away from dry and rigid religious interpretations towards an open horizon of compassion for all human beings living on earth. This is what I noticed having observed the Jamaat, and the dignity, patience and tolerance and a balanced interpretation of Islamic teachings demonstrates a peaceful and serene life practiced under the shade of divine guidance, which is pleasing to see after centuries of violence and bloodshed in the name of religion. One of the beautiful aspects that was clearly visible was the harmony between Ahmadiyya teachings and modern civilizations. And I hope that the Ahmadiyya teachings spread rapidly with all its grandeur and glory amongst the Muslims and all those living on this earth, so that everyone can experience a successful and prosperous life and attain salvation. A guest from Belize, Roland Heidsaib, says that he cannot put the sentiments he felt during the bad ceremony into words. He could feel the presence of God. And he further says that many of the men were crying profusely, seeking forgiveness from Allah the Almighty, and without fear of any worldly judgment. The bad ceremony experience has left a lasting impression on his life, and to see such a vast number of people gather together without any alcohol or music was extraordinary. Each person was trying to increase in the spirituality, and this is something truly praiseworthy. It was a truly life-changing experience. And it was not only those on duty, but seeing the participants of Jalsa Salana is also a form of silent tabligh. A missionary from Bolivia writes, Carlos Higgins Sahib attended the Jalsa this year, and this is his third time. He had been studying Islam for some time and did the Baith a month ago. He says that he had the opportunity to attend the international Baith ceremony at the Jalsa. Carlos Sahib says that Jalsa Salana UK is the most important spiritual experience of my life. Having participated in the international Baith ceremony, I feel as though my heart and my soul is filled with spirituality and that I have become a true Ahmadi. He further writes that as a new convert, the Khalifa of the time has advised me that I should pray with full concentration and to forge a strong connection with God, and also that I should direct the attention of the Ahmadi Jamaat members in Bolivia towards reading the Holy Quran. And he says that he will act on this himself and also inform others. Maria Soles Franco Sahiba, a non-Ahmadi guest from Uruguay, says that the Jalsa Salana far exceeded my expectations. Firstly, the accommodation for guests was exemplary, and the speeches were mesmerizing. And the inaugural session was my favorite. It is very important that we spread the message of love for all, hatred for none. Overall, I found a pleasant atmosphere of brotherhood, and the administration played an outstanding role in this. She says that despite being such a large gathering, I never saw a congestion of people, nor did it ever seem like it was out of control. There was good planning and clearly marked signs for cars, which demonstrated excellent logistics. Undoubtedly, this has impressed countless of those in attendance. Attending the Jalsa has had a positive impact on my spirituality, and the most memorable moment was on Sunday when Ahmadis recited the pledge, i.e. the Baith, where everyone prayed together and cried profusely. I have never seen such a firm resolve in one's faith before this. If I was to suggest something for the guests, then it would be that there should be more activities for guests during the convention. Furthermore, female guests should not be compelled to wear the hijab. However, they are not compelled to wear this, so either she is under a misconception or perhaps a worker said this of their own accord. But it is my belief that usually we do not tell them to wear it. Nonetheless, she says that the hijab should certainly be present and they should wear it if they wish. But in any case, what we do say is that one should wear modest clothes. Lorena Vela, a guest from Costa Rica, writes that in Costa Rica, I am in regular contact with Muslim organizations, but I do not see any participation from women whatsoever. In fact, only men represent their faith, all of whom are designated to some office or position or another. However, having attended the Jalsa of the Ahmadiyya community, I was astonished and pleased to see that in the Ahmadiyya community, women and men are equal. On the second day, when she went to the ladies' side, she said that the discipline and cleanliness was far better. She further says that I was informed that the Ahmadiyya community is working to establish peace, harmony, and interfaith dialogue throughout the world. And initially, I thought that all this was limited to mere statements. However, after attending the Jalsa, I've experienced this firsthand and can attest that whatever the Ahmadiyya community instructs others to do, they act upon it themselves as well. And the actions and words of the Jamaat members are the same. A guest from Burundi, Hantungi Manna Ponten Sahib, is the Secretary for the Ministry of National Solidarity, Social Affairs and Human Rights, Burundi. Whilst mentioning his sentiments, he says, "I was warmly received from the airport up to the accommodation." He then says, "The young volunteers greeted me and were very hospitable. I will never forget the 3 days of sincere love and affection shown in the hospitality, which was without discrimination of race, background or religion." He says that even though my beliefs are slightly different, but we are all the creation of Allah, who loves everyone, and we share the same blood. The speeches at Jalsa were filled with the teachings of Islam and shed light on the erroneous interpretations that have been done by others regarding the Ahmadiyya teachings and answer their questions. He then says, "The report on your success throughout the world indicates that you assist people who have special requirements, and through relevant planning, you do your part in helping them." He then says that, "I am a witness to those services in my country of Burundi." He further says, "It is not the work of a human being to organize such a large conference. It is only the work of Allah the Almighty. And this is a clear and mighty sign that whatever you do, it is always supported by the hand of Allah the Almighty." He then offered prayers that may Allah the Almighty always protect you. A non-Ahmadi guest from Iceland, Suleiman Barsaib, who is originally from the Gambia, says, "Participating in the Jalsa Salana increased my knowledge about the Jamaat. He further states that after visiting the various exhibitions, I saw the work Jamaat is doing around the world, and I am deeply impacted by the manner in which the Jamaat strives to attain knowledge and to further spread it. I was also deeply impressed by the fact that despite an attendance of 43,000 people, the segregation between men and women was maintained, and they were both working in their respective areas." He says that, "I have attended many Islamic gatherings and programs, and even though the attendance consists of a few thousand people, there is still interaction taking place between men and women. However, despite such a large gathering in the Jalsa, segregation was maintained, which is no ordinary matter. Thus, this is also a form of silent tabligh for these people, which is done through our conduct." He then says the Jamaat should be commended for this, and the arrangements and organization of the Jalsa were extremely excellent. Everyone was treating one another with great respect, and the workers were cheerfully carrying out their duties. The entire organization of the event was running in a smooth fashion, and this was not merely the result of a few days of preparation. Rather, these preparations were being carried out from a long time." He further says that at the accommodation I was in, which was in Jamia, the mattresses had been laid out and everyone slept there. There was no distinction between anyone and all of the guests were being treated equally. He also gave a suggestion for further improvement and he said that although there was air conditioning in the Jalsa Gah, however, it was still hot and it seemed that there was a lack of air ventilation, as a result of which I began to feel sleepy. He says that, "I initially thought perhaps it was just me, but when I looked to my right and left at other people, they would also sometimes doze off. Therefore, there should be some arrangements for air circulation in order to keep everyone fresh." The missionary from Argentina writes, "Mariana Plaza Saiba is the ambassador of Argentina to the United Kingdom, and she attended the Jalsa for the first time. She was so impressed by the atmosphere of the Jalsa and the event that she held an official reception at the embassy and invited all the non-Ahmadi guests who attended the Jalsa from Latin America. And during this reception, the ambassador of Argentina particularly expressed her thanks to the non-Ahmadi government officials who attended the Jalsa of the Ahmadiyya community and played their role in promoting the message of the community. She also stated that generally religious organizations only invite diplomats and politicians for these special external events, and after inviting them for a particular session, then bid them farewell. However, this was completely contrary to it, and a rather extraordinary and commendable fact that your community did not hide anything from us non-Ahmadi guests. And this shows that you do not have any hidden agenda. In fact, your teachings are clear, and whatever teaching you present before those who are not members of your community is in complete harmony with your inner beliefs and agendas. Dr. Eleni Saiba, an editor of a Brazilian newspaper, attended the Jalsa. She says that I was extremely impressed in every respect by this extraordinary gathering, particularly by its structure and the fact that despite such a large attendance, people were interacting with one another with such great love and harmony, and also by the sheer arrangements of it all, which made it possible for this to be a successful Jalsa in every respect. I was very delighted by the atmosphere of peace, unity and love, and the wise words of the head of the community touched my heart and opened my mind towards goodness. She then further states that the words of the Khalifa of the time were not just mere words. Rather, it seemed as if they were emanating sincerely from his heart, and I experienced love and respect in every moment during the Jalsa. The cheerful manner in which the volunteers carried out their duties most certainly impacted my heart and is commendable. Then a newspaper journalist from Brazil says, "This was an extraordinary Jalsa, and my respect and admiration for the Ahmadiyya community has further increased after the Jalsa. The selfless service rendered by the volunteers attracted my attention as to how they devoted their time, cars and services for the guests, and this was indeed an excellent thing." Roberto Catalano is a professor in interfaith dialogue at the University of Florence in Italy. He attended the Jalsa and said that I was left astounded by this event. This Jalsa brings together many thousands of people from different nations of the world. This demonstrated the commendable unity of the Ahmadiyya community. A spiritual atmosphere could be felt in this Jalsa, and it was amazing to see how people were completely silent and giving their full attention when the head of the community was speaking, and this created a deeply spiritual atmosphere. The passion of the volunteers was very impressive, and thousands of volunteers, which including children, worked with great effort. He then says, "One of the most memorable moments of the Jalsa was the international bath ceremony, in which the bath was done at the hand of the Khalifa of the time. This holy and extraordinary event united 40,000 people, which is a powerful proof of their collective faith and devotion." He then says that I have particularly learnt a lot more about the persecution against the community in Pakistan and the challenges it faces. And despite these struggles and afflictions, for them to not express any kind of hatred greatly impressed me and is a true testament of your faith. The Women's Affairs and Family Welfare Commissioner from Rodriguez Island, Agatha Mary Saiba, also attended. She says that this was the first time I attended such a large event where people from more than 100 countries were in attendance belonging to different ethnicities. And for me to take part in an event along with almost 44,000 people is almost equal to the total population of the Rodriguez Island. And what completely melted my heart was the manner in which the people attending the Jalsa Salana sat with such discipline. Everyone was smiling and greeting one another, and this is very commendable. She then says that the head of the community's address to the Lajna was also very profound. And I learned that the women in the Ahmadiyya Muslim community play an important role. And I am certain that this address will bring about positive impact in my policies. I have learned a great deal at this Jalsa, which shall bring about a positive change in me and also in those around me. She says that I have attended many religious events in the past, and I knew deep in my heart that there were some spiritual aspects in me which were lacking. However, the Jalsa was such an event that fulfilled all my shortcomings. Such sentiments were expressed by many people, that they were lacking in certain aspects of their spirituality and that they were able to find a better atmosphere here. Temu Anderson Sahiba from Tanzania is serving as an ambassador of Tanzania at the United Nations in Geneva. She says that after coming here, I witnessed love and smiles and did not see any kind of hatred during these days. The session in the ladies was extremely insightful and impressive, and the exhibitions I visited during the Jalsa were very beautiful, in which the founder of the community and the elders of the community were introduced in an excellent manner. The history of the founder of this strong community and its heroes was presented in a beautiful manner. The Ahmadiyya community has made a significant change in the lives of people, which includes my beautiful country, Tanzania. She then says that this Jalsa gave the opportunity to value human sympathy and to live with one another with love and without any kind of hatred. Justice Ivan Sise, a guest from Sierra Leone, states, "The 3 days of the Jalsa Salana were days of peace, spiritual growth, and global unity. The organization of the event was exceptional, and there was no distinction of race or color. Everyone was working side by side, and each person, whether a child or an adult, was performing their assigned duties remarkably well, which astonished me." He then says that these speakers, including distinguished dignitaries and scholars, delivered deep insights and inspiring messages that touched everyone's hearts. He says that I was particularly impressed by the emphasis on peace, unity and understanding. There were numerous activities and exhibitions that made the Jalsa lively, and the educational exhibitions were well presented, offering historical and cultural insights. He further says that I had many opportunities to meet and converse with people from diverse backgrounds, which fostered feelings of unity and brotherhood. And a significant moment for me was the keynote address, where the head of the Ahmadiyya community highlighted the importance of compassion and service to humanity. His emphasis on the role of parents and the negative impacts on children in the absence of parental guidance due to social media or electronic networks was enlightening and serves as a guideline for the parents. He then says, the arrangements, speeches and service of the community members at the Jalsa Salana greatly exceeded my expectations. Gul Saira Angali Sahiba, a guest from Kazakhstan, says that I attended such a grand religious convention for the first time. As a former politician, I am aware of the costs and extensive planning required for such large-scale arrangements and the tireless efforts of many people involved. And I was deeply impressed by the enthusiasm and joy with which all the volunteers were performing their duties in every department. Despite their hard work, each volunteer treated the guests with love, respect and affection. She says, however, what impressed me the most were the addresses of the Khalifa of the time. Though the addresses seemed to discuss everyday ethics, however, they had a profound and broad subject matter behind them. She says, I particularly appreciated his clear and direct comments on the negative effects of social media and children's upbringing. I learned a lot and now intend to apply these lessons in my life. And when speaking to my grandchildren, I will explain that we should not forget our morals in our pursuit of success in life. She was so impressed that she said, although I came as a guest this time, but I am confident that I will soon join this community because I resonate with what I heard at this Jalsa. Gosh Sankofa Sahib, a guest from Belize, states, "How can one deny that Ahmadiyyat is the true Islam? All my doubts and questions have been answered when I see how much love the Ahmadiyya community has for the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. I realize that Ahmadiyyat is a great strong tree with many fruitful branches." Amalia, a guest from Spain and a professor of psychology at the University of Cordoba, writes, "As a psychology professor, I was very interested in learning about your experiences. And so I took the opportunity to observe these moments, which have become preserved as cherished memories that I will fondly remember." She then goes on to say that the diversity and vastness of the Jalsa and the peace and harmony felt in every corner deeply impressed me. Abrik Zakraj, a physics professor from the University of Kosovo, says that it was my first time attending the Jalsas in the UK. And after listening to the Friday sermon of the Khalifa of the time, I noticed an immediate improvement in the overall atmosphere. There was a visible display of love and affection between the volunteers and guests. And smiling faces and the greetings of Assalamu Alaikum were heard everywhere. Such an environment can be likened to paradise. If such an atmosphere can be created in such a large gathering, then it is not far-fetched to believe that it can be established worldwide, but only the Ahmadiyya community can accomplish this. And what impressed me the most was how, even if a volunteer was forced to deny a guest out of necessity, then a solution was immediately provided to ensure the guests were well taken care of. He then says that I was astonished by the sight of different nations coming together as one during the bath ceremony, as if they were pearls strung together in a single thread. A non-Ahmadi journalist from Uruguay says that before attending the Jalsa, I had many expectations and prejudices. And to understand Islam closely, and specifically the work of your community is doing, was essential for my project in Uruguay. She says that the first day speech, where the Khalifa spoke about hospitality, was particularly inspiring. Because as a guest, I believe we might expect an interfaith message, but these messages were direct towards the community, and I felt very comfortable in the atmosphere of constant praise and glorification of God Almighty. She further said that I learned a lot about different cultures within the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, which dispelled many of my prejudices. I was not allowed to record anything from the women's side. However, I feel there was no danger or harm in doing so. If by this she meant taking pictures, then it is good that she did not take any. Otherwise, it was fine for her to record anything else or to acquire the recordings later. In any case, the missionary from there can explain it to her further. She then said, "Nonetheless, there was no harm in granting permission as it would have allowed us to create better material to publish in our country. Participating in the Jalsa Salana has significantly impacted my spiritual life, and the most memorable moment for me was seeing men cry in prayer to Allah the Almighty." She says that, "I believe that the participation of journalists can be better organized to improve the coverage of the event. My suggestion is to spread the work and working methods of the community more widely to the world." Apana Petruska Saiba, a guest from Poland who works in customer support department, attended the Jalsa, and she says that, "I believe in God, but do not consider myself part of any religion. And I was introduced to the community by an Ahmadi who used to work with me. And I got the sense that he felt a great deal of pride about his community and he would often tell others about it. Hence, I too had some information about the Ahmadi community, as well as some links to certain websites. She says, after doing some research, I decided to attend the Jalsa Salana UK, and I even bought my clothes and a scarf for the Jalsa. When I began my journey towards the Jalsa, I had mixed feelings, and I was also a little scared. She continues that on the very first day of Jalsa, I did not know which way to go to the Jalsa site. Meanwhile, without my asking, a girl asked me if I needed any help, which was very surprising for me. Upon arriving at the Jalsa site, I immediately began feeling safe. And even though there were so many people, I did not feel alienated in any way. She says that during the Jalsa, the various speeches, especially the addresses by the head of the community, strengthened my bond with the community. She then says that for me, the most memorable part was the address delivered to the ladies, in which guidance was given as to how children should be raised. During the address, I kept thinking about my own children and the fact that I completely agree with the boundaries which the head of the community mentioned in his speech. And I consider all of them to be very important and think that they were worth mentioning. A professor from the University of Pristina in Kosovo said, whilst mentioning his impressions, he says, I attended the Jalsa Salana for the first time and I witnessed love and affection everywhere. In my view, this Jalsa was extremely successful, especially the exhibitions. He is from Kosovo and he says that I was very troubled to hear about the persecution faced by the community throughout the world. The concluding address delivered by the head of the community drew my attention towards the fact that Islam Ahmadiyya is the true teaching, and I received the answers to my questions. When I return to Kosovo, I will respond to those who speak out against the beliefs of the community. Then Mr. Cherkwan, a guest from Holland, says that the hospitality of the Ahmadiyya community and the volunteer efforts made by thousands impacted me a great deal. There was an atmosphere of respect, love and peace for all. He then goes on to say that I also met the head of the community, which was a very good experience. He says that not only did he meet us, but he also took the time to answer questions about Islam from both Ahmadis and non-Ahmadis alike, and I greatly benefited from this. He says that these things have become ingrained in my heart, and without growing weary, he carefully listened to what we had to say and then gave us answers. These were just some impressions which I have mentioned. And the report of births which took place as a result of the Jalsa Salana is as follows. The chief of a village in Guinea-Bissau, along with 85 people, accepted Ahmadiyyat after watching the Jalsa proceedings. The imam of a mosque in a village of Tanzania also accepted Ahmadiyyat, and a school teacher from Niger accepted Ahmadiyyat, and during the Jalsa, 12 people from Congo Brazzaville accepted Ahmadiyyat. A missionary from Guinea-Bissau writes, the Sare Kucha is a place in Guinea-Bissau where the chief was severely opposed to the Ahmadiyya community. And during the Jalsa Salana, he watched the Jalsa proceedings and listened to my addresses as he had been invited to do so. He says that after listening to these addresses, he said that your Khalifa and the founder of your community are true lovers of the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. We had always been told that the Ahmadiyya community does not accept the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, to be a prophet, and have instead taken their own prophet. But after listening to the address delivered by your Imam, I have become certain that your community alone is the true community of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. At that very instance, along with 85 people, he announced that he had accepted Ahmadiyyat. And so he who was once an opponent entered the fold of the community. May Allah also grant sense to the Pakistani clerics as well. The Imam of a mosque in the Abuja village of Tanzania says that I was left astonished upon witnessing the proceedings of Jalsa Salana and MTA. These scenes were very impactful. During the bath, there were some very emotional moments, and I was astonished that everyone was repeating after the words of a single leader and then prayed as well. These scenes have entirely changed me and have left a deep impact on me. God willing, I shall always remain a part of this community. I was the Imam in a Sunni mosque, but now I'm a heartfelt Ahmadi and have completely changed. The report from the Tabligh department in the UK is that during the Jalsa, 22 people from the UK were able to accept Ahmadiyyat. They comprised of 2 British, 2 Nigerian, 11 Pakistanis, 1 Romanian, 5 Arabs and a Bengali. There were about 1,000 non-Ahmadi guests who attended the Jalsa, and during the Jalsa, various Tabligh sessions were also held, which included question and answer sessions. And in these, people expressed their impressions. Under MTA Africa, there were more than 14 national television channels who relayed my addresses. They also transmitted the international Baat ceremony live, which was watched by several million people. The new African channels who joined in this were Malawi's national TV channel, Canal Plus TV in Benin, and the government channels of the Gambia, Ghana, Uganda, Liberia, and Sierra Leone. And these channels are viewed by approximately more than 30 million people. Then there were 14 different television journalists who participated in the Jalsa, and 57 reports were broadcasted. These reports reached more than 55 million people. Arrangements were made in the Senegal Mission House to listen to the Jalsa. An imam who teaches the Holy Quran, Hadith, and jurisprudence at a college said after the Jalsa concluded that I consider myself lucky because today I had the opportunity of seeing the Khalifa of the Imam Mahdi live and listening to his address. Before this, I had many doubts about the Ahmadiyya community, such as that, God forbid, Ahmadis diminish the rank of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. However, today, after listening to the address of Khalifatul Masih, all of my doubts in this regard have been dispelled. And after listening to today's speech, I can confidently say that the Ahmadiyya community does not dishonor the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Rather, it has a great deal of sincerity and love for him, and teaches the entire world to follow and obey the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. The report about online coverage is that last year this numbered 41, whereas this year there were 49 websites which are read by 15 million people, according to the reports. As for print coverage, there were 14 articles, and the readership of those newspapers is 5 million, according to the reports. 19 reports were relayed via television and radio, and it is reported that the viewership is 10 million. The viewership of the television channels is 10 million, while there were a total of 24 reports broadcast on the radio, and the number of listeners is also 10 million. By the grace of Allah the Almighty, approximately more than 46 million people saw or heard the news of the Jalsa Salana. And it is said that in the coming few days, it is expected that there will be even more coverage and quite prominent radio channels, such as LBC, Radio Scotland, BBC, BBC South Today, and Daily Express, and others have published reports. Similarly, as I had mentioned, that many people visited the exhibitions, such as the Makhzan-e-Tasavir exhibition, and upon seeing the history exhibition, as well as other exhibitions, people were greatly impacted by them. And all of these exhibitions were also a form of tabligh. By the grace of Allah the Almighty, on the one hand, the Jalsa has been a means of increasing in spirituality and moral training. And on the other hand, it has been a means of informing external guests about the teachings of Islam and to better their understanding, as well as a means of bringing them closer to God. Thus, owing to this, while we must bow down and be thankful to God Almighty more than before, at the same time, we must follow the pledge that we will always strive to spread the message of Allah the Almighty and the promised Messiah alayhi salam even more than before. May Allah the Almighty enable us to do so.
Alhamdulillah. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وَنُؤْمِنُ بِهِ وَنَتَوَكَّلُ عَلَيْهِ وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ وَنَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَنَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر